Blackstone Audio presents The Kundalini Equation by Stephen Barnes. This book is read by Ron Butler. Chapter 1. The Legend. This whole world was enveloped by death, by hunger. For what is death but hunger? And death bethought himself, "Would that I had a self." Book 1, verse 2, The Upanishads. 1500 BC, Indus Valley, India. In silence, concealed within an angled web of temple rafters, Jari notched an arrow to his bowstring and sighted along its shaft at the priest beneath him. The old man was pinned to the blood-stained frescoed wall by spikes through his wrists. His toes barely reached the ground. End his pain. Jari lowered his arrow's silver tip. He could do nothing but watch. The squat, muscular spearmen on either side of the priest snapped to attention as a new figure entered the temple of Kalarangpur. The newcomer was thick-chested, with the shoulders of an ape. His scarred face mirrored the hideous carnage just beyond the temple's shattered, metal-bound doors. His armor and carriage proclaimed him an officer. Something round and flat beneath one massive arm caught the smoldering torch's glare, throwing it back to the wall in flashes of white. Behind the officer waddled a small, grotesquely obese figure whose feet slapped a clumsy rhythm on the tile. His rags, matted with filth, fluttered about him like a shroud. A scrap of cloth swathed his face diagonally from scalp to chin, covering his left eye. One of the beggars who sought alms in the marketplace, now licking up behind his true master. Jari growled and aligned the tip of his arrow with the back of the spy's neck. The officer thumbed back the priest's eyelid and spat directly into the iris. The old man convulsed, the spikes tugging cruelly at his wrists. The officer said something in a guttural tongue and threw down a silver plate veined with tiny rivulets of gold. It rolled on edge to the priest's feet and clattered to the ground. The ragged spy snatched it up. "The general wants to know where this came from." His voice was a barely comprehensible mishmash of barbaric consonants. "The etching, the molding are much finer than anything else in Kalarangpur." His bandaged finger lightly traced the elegantly carved image of a sacred bull. "The general has seen such plates, but they were old, tarnished. This is new, the metal freshly cast." There was no reply. Like a hawk seizing a rabbit, the general's hand flashed out, fingers sinking deeply into the priest's wizened throat. He twisted the old man's head around until their eyes locked. "You don't have to die," the spy said. The priest coughed painfully, then spoke for the first time. "All men die." The spy peeled the bandage away from his face, blinking against the light. "But why die here, today, in agony?" He called sharply, again in the barbarian tongue, and two guards prodded a trio of children into the temple at spear point. The priest's knees sagged. He groaned as fresh blood oozed from his wrists. Two of the children were girls, both nearing womanhood. The youngest was a boy, his initiate's robe ripped and muddied. Although his legs trembled, he stood tall and met the general's gaze squarely. Silently, Jari chanted his admiration. The general clapped his hands, and both girls were hurled to the ground. He twined his fingers into the hair of the eldest and jerked her head up, laughing as he made a vulgar hand gesture. "Just tell us," the spy said. "Tell us about the plates, and we will let your miserable village rot in peace." The priest's lips trembled slightly, a single tear rolling from beneath his sunken eyelids. "Death holds few terrors for you," the spy whispered. "But these are just children. Children who need you to think clearly, sanely." His voice was almost brotherly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.